interesting way of putting it, Seamus.
No doubt. I do interesting very well. It's trusting I don't do so well.
Oh, please. I know how to work with good people, Seamus, and I work in the right way.
Well, they all say that. I never met an idiot that called himself one.
Partner, this is Seamus. He's our new partner.
I ain't no such thing.
Prospective new partner, if he likes us.
Liking ain't the problem. Trusting is, as I said. Keep your voices down. I don't want my boss hearing. This is a sideline.
Of course. Look at us. Honest as the day is long.
Exactly.
I'll tell you what. Let us prove ourselves.
Prove ourselves? To this clown? What you talking about?
Good day, Hosea. Good luck with your business dealings.
Listen, he's rough and ready and quick with his tongue, but I swear you can trust him and trust me.
I'm an old man.
You're not old, Seamus.
I'm old enough. And you know why I ain't dead?
You don't trust idiots.
Exactly.
We're not idiots. Let us prove it to you.
Okay. I'll tell you what.
Arthur!
Old Bob Crawford and his boys just bought a beautiful stolen stagecoach from upstate. It's in their barn. Now, you go get that. And then we can work together.
Who's old Bob Crawford?
An acquaintance of mine.
So you want us to take out your competition?
Well, he's not just an acquaintance, but a cousin. By marriage. I also want to see if your boys got what it takes. Now, you survive that.
Where is he?
Well, he's in a farmhouse just northwest of here called Carmody Dell. It's just up the train tracks as you're heading up towards Fort Wallace. There's also some money in that house, but that's your business, not mine. But don't kill nobody. Folks know we ain't intimate no more, and they'll know it was me.
But you're fine with us robbing your cousin.
By marriage. And yes, I'd love it.
You heard the man. Let's go rob his cousin.
By marriage.
Really?
Look out, Arthur.
Lead the way. He said the place is just northwest of here.
Me?
Arthur?
You're the one who's been out gallivanting around here.
That's what you call it. Well, clearly you've recovered from your bear encounter.
Whoa! Could have played that better, couldn't you?
Thought you wanted me here to show some strong arm. That's usually how it goes.
Yes, but... you know how this works.
Come on, Hosea. That feller's a joke.
And that's why he's perfect. He won't cause us any problems. A safe spot to fence wagons and coaches? That's easy money for us.
I guess you're right.
Come on, it's not like he's asking us to rob a bank. If the two of us can't steal the stagecoach from Seamus's old crooked cousin by marriage, we should hang up our hats now.
Feeling about things now?
What things?
This place. The gang. Been here a few weeks now.
Good, I think. Better.
I figured more folks would have cut and run on us, given everything that happened.
Like Dutch always says, a lone wolf don't last long out on the plains.
He does like to trot that one out.
Watch out!
People see that. Especially when they get a few years on them. Even someone like Micah.
There's a couple of folks I wish had come through.
Hey, let's keep it down now. We must be close. That must be the place up ahead. We should go on foot from here. Let's see what we're dealing with. Come on. There's the house. I see the barn in the back. Stagecoach has to be in there. Okay, let's take a quick look at the place.
Anyone?
Nope. Okay. I reckon we could do it now.
Sneak in, I'll get the coach. You can try the house.
Or
wait until morning, when I'll head over, distract them by putting on a little show. While you sneak into the house, find what you can, and then get the stagecoach. What do you think?
Let's do it now.
All right. I reckon we're ready. Let's go. Maybe take a peek through the windows before you go in. Make sure it's all quiet. Thank you.
Get on, dear boy. Come on, get on and let's head back. Everything we needed. Take it easy, Arthur.
And I'm pretty sure they never even knew I was there.
Best way. Less problems, the better right now. Just need to get this back to Seamus in one piece, and it's a good night's work. So what were you able to lift from the house?
A few bits and pieces. Nothing too fancy.
Well, we need anything we can get right now.
Yeah. This was easier than hunting a 1,000-pound grizzly, anyway.
No doubt. I won't forget that in a hurry.
I'm looking forward to your retelling of that one around the campfire.
It wasn't the first time Mr. Matthews had stared death in the eye. And as usual, he did not flinch.
Yeah, exactly. How long you think we're gonna stick around here for?
Not sure. Until we can't, I suppose. Feels like we're starting to get back on our feet, slowly but surely. Just need to keep at it. Dutch has a new money chest stashed in a safe spot away from camp, but it's a long way from being full.
I hope it's not stashed in town like we did at Blackwater. Even if we had to dump the money from the ferry, we could have at least got the rest out if it was hidden someplace else.
No, I think we've learned our lesson there. And a few other lessons besides. Okay, here we are. Just pull the coach into the barn there. Hello, Seamus. We met your cousins.
How was it?
Fine. Nice people.
Park that thing in here. Quickly. Nice work, Hosea.
It was mostly Arthur. Like I said, coarse, but competent.
Here.
Thank you.
If you find any other coaches that need selling, I'll see what I can offer you for them. But discreet, you know.
Of course.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
I'm heading back to camp, I think. You coming?
What's wrong? Thought you'd be happy to be off that mountain.
Oh, I don't know.
You ain't been yourself for a while.
We'll be right back. Mr. Morgan, I took your advice, sir. I took your advice.
Then your god has finally deserted you. What you talking about?
I took your advice, sir. I have removed myself from Morpheus's embrace. No more shall I sink, sir. I am free. I am free.
You don't seem free, friend. You seem drunk.
Sit down, Reverend. We ain't finished.
You ain't finished. Look at him, he's finished.
None of us forced liquor down his throat. Friend, I just want him to play.
Now, firstly, we ain't friends. Don't make no mistake on that subject. Now, secondly, he can't hardly see, let alone reason. Now, reasoning ain't never been one of my strong points neither, but seeing I do just fine. You want to step outside or do a business here?
I just want him to finish the game.
Why can't we all just get along? These are good men, Arthur. They're children of God. They're children of God.
How's about you playing his place, huh? That seems fair.
Fair?
Sure. You want a game?
Sure. I'll play a few hands.
Well, sit yourself down then. I'm Luther. This is Marvin.
Fortunate for you both, we're being gentlemen about this.
Same goes for you.
So, how you two know each other anyway? Don't seem like the likeliest of friends, if you don't mind me saying.
We go a long way back.
And now you're his chaperone?
I guess it's something like that. Can we play?
I check.
He can't be no real clergyman. He committed about 5 cardinal sins just in that chair you're sitting in.
I think he used to be. He's drifted a little in recent years. Life is a challenge to all of us.
Check.
Check. Can you imagine him at the pulpit? If he could stand up.
On the 4th day, he turned water into whiskey, and I don't remember much after that.
He's a decent fella going through a bad time.
Disrespect him again, and you'll find yourself in a bad time, too.
All right, all right. Just trying to have a little fun here. It is a game, after all, mister.
I reckon all in.
I'll call.
Okay. Here, look.
Hardly a big finale from me.
Don't laugh.
Ho-ho!
For Christ's sakes.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Let's go.
Are you kidding me?
Gentlemen. This is getting too rich for me.
Sit down.
Oh, I'm done, friend. It's been a real education. Come on, Rip. Where is he? Where'd he go?
Who?
The Reverend. Where it? Excuse me, gentlemen. Reverend! Reverend Swanson! Where'd you go? Excuse me, I'm sorry. You see a drunken idiot, a priest, wandering about?
Sure, we saw him, smelt him, and avoided him. He went that way, I think.
Thanks.
Guy looked kind of crazy, mister.
Well, you have no idea. Off him.
You'll keep. You stay out of it.
Get your hands off him now, you son of a bitch. Ah.
What the hell is your problem? What the hell is your problem?
Killed him. I'm gonna get the law on you.
Hey, you! Get back here! Friend, it's just a simple mistake. You can still be saved. What have you done with your foot?
It appears to like this place and wants to stay.
Get your foot out of here. Twist your leg, you drunken bastard. Help! Help me over! Get it! Come on!
There was
a goddamn train, you crazy bastard!
Have I been bad again, Mr. Morgan? I'm sorry. I wish I was different. Home. Yeah, that's a wonderful idea. I could have tea with Margaret.
Margaret, who's Margaret?
But...
I was wondering when he'd show up.
Better sleep your way to salvation, my friend.
What happened?
Just the usual.
Poor bastard.
Exactly.
Well, thank you, Mr. Morgan. I'll keep an eye on him.
He was lucky this time. Real lucky.
the way from here to California.
Yeah, I know who the Jack Hall gang are.
Oh, them you have heard of, but me? Huh. Well, rumor has it they buried gold somewhere in this area, but were killed before they could retrieve it. They created two maps to ensure it was well hidden. This is the first and should lead you to the second. You just need to follow the landmarks drawn here.
Me?
Yes! Unfortunately, I am out of time now, but I am prepared to sell it to you for the low price of $10. A trifling investment for a man such as you, given the potential returns. Well, $10, and it's yours.
Why not?
A very wise investment. I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Morgans everywhere.
You see Sean?
No, I don't think so.
Damn it. Where's Trelawney?
Who knows?
Hey. Just...
Where is that little Irish pest?
I'm not quite sure. Trelawney's off trying to find out.
Has anyone been in the Blackwater, see how things lie?
Place is crawling with Pinkertons, bounty hunters, pictures of Dutch and Hosea.
We got a lot of money sitting in that town.
And that's where it's gonna remain for now.
Why haven't they hanged Sean, I wonder?
I think he's bait. Well, they want to trial him publicly.
Gentlemen, Sean is being moved up the Upper Montana, then to a federal prison out west.
Damn. Well, we can't be rescuing people from some federal prison. We either rescue him now or cut him loose.
We're not cutting anyone loose.
Of course not.
Ike Skelding's boys are moving him to a camp nearby before handing him over to the government.
So...